we're coming face to face with the power of the Atlantic Ocean. And getting to meet the birds that thrive here.
Look at the wings on this guy.
Wow.
I'm Alizé Carrère, an environmental anthropologist and National Geographic explorer. This is my friend Tom Ritchie, a naturalist who spent decades in the field. Together, we'll discover what it means to be a modern explorer. Today, we're going on an expedition to the Falkland Islands, an archipelago about 300 miles east of the South American mainland. We're trekking across one of the hundreds of islands that make up the Falkland Islands.
I have a feeling this is going to be a bumpy ride.
That's all right by me.
Our destination? Where the howling ocean collides with the coast. The nesting spot of one of nature's great travelers. The black-browed albatross. They're massive birds that spend most of their time at sea. Their wingspans are around 7.5 feet from tip to tip. And in flight, they look like they're floating. That's because they only flap their wings when they absolutely have to. Albatross ride on powerful ocean winds, saving them energy. But it's not the adults that have caught my eye. It's this hillside of downy chicks.
So these are black-browed albatross chicks.
Oh, those albatross are so beautiful. They're enormous.
The interesting thing is when birds fledge, they're the same size as the parents.
Is that true across the board?
Yeah, well, those that keep their chicks in nests, yeah, they're as big as the parents when they leave the nest.
Right.
You can see they're already getting their flight feathers, but they're still covered with down. Look at the wings on this guy. And what I love is how when they fold their wings up, they accordion them up into place. And so even though they have such huge wings, they don't look like they're oversized wings when they're folded up.
The parents of these young ones are out to sea, where they forage for food to bring back to their chicks. But what's lovely about black-browed albatross is that they tend to pair bond for life. Season after season, they'll come back here to reunite with their mate. They'll touch beaks and preen each other in elaborate courtship displays.
Does the same mother or father albatross pick the same nest every year?
Yeah, they use it over and over. That nest there has been used probably for 25, 30 years.
Albatross can live decades. That means that some of these birds are probably older than I am. I wish we could join the seasoned parents on their hunt at sea. But on foot, Tom and I can only follow so far.
Oh,
man.
That's incredible.
The albatross is zipping over our heads at 60 miles an hour. I mean, it's awesome, isn't it?
It really is. You just feel the energy coming off the water.
The roiling ocean is the key to this whole ecosystem. Its rich waters feed the birds here, but the island's isolation and rough waves also kept it undeveloped. The first settlement wasn't established until 1764. Today, about 3,500 people call the archipelago home. But you wouldn't know it standing here, which is what makes this coastline so appealing to visitors like Tom and me. Ecotourism has become a critical part of the local economy.
What a world.
Yeah.
Which means these islands really can be for the birds. Our tools are different, our technology is different, and the landscape is changing. Exploring means something very different from the past. But there will always be room to observe and protect the wonder of our world. And that's what makes a modern explorer.